ourselves and just by sharing what we're doing every day on social media, we can have that amount of impact. And that is incredible. So it's our team. It's amazing. Everybody's doing so great. And I just wanted to call out those people who were a part of that 49. And Michelle, she's not on the call, but she helped change 11 people's lives last month. 11. Melanie, 6. I helped 5 people. Tyann helped 6. Shonda helped 5. Chanel helped 3. Lena helped 3. Allison helped 3 people. Kristen, Laureen, Mary, Tracy, and Susanna, they helped 1 person. I mean, that's to say that you had a hand in just helping 1 person, you know, last month is incredible. So congratulations, everybody. Great job. I also wanted to recognize the new coaches on our team. Our team grew a lot last month. Michelle added 6 new coaches to our team. I added 4 new coaches. Kristen, Mary, and Tyann and Chanel added 1 new coach, and Shoda added 4 new coaches. So that was just last month. And that's pretty incredible, because I remember when our team, we were adding like 1 new coach a month. So we're growing. And I just wanted to recognize that, because it's really powerful. And I know everybody's plugged in to the Team P page. And you see that volume every month and those volume leaders. I know, Melanie, you're like number 2 this month or last month. That's incredible. So we're doing it right. You know, we're using the tools that we're given, and we're sharing with our heart. And because of that, we're influencing people in a positive way, and they're making the decision to join us. And that just makes me feel really good about what we're doing, how we're doing it, because we are impacting so many people, and 49 people, that's pretty awesome. So I just wanted to share that with you guys. And Lena advanced her husband to Emerald. So we had a rank advancement last month. Anybody else want to shout out to someone on your team or recognize anybody on your team? Go ahead.
I want to recognize Courtney, because I know she has been really having a struggle. And even though she's struggling, like, she's showing up for herself and she's sharing her journey authentically, like not trying to sugarcoat it. And I just admire that so much. And it so speaks to exactly what Jenn Richardson was saying. And I even wrote it down because it's so important. She says, vulnerability breeds connection. So bravo. Oh, yeah, and shout out to my husband, because he got a coach last month. Don't forget about Richard, because he worked really hard.
Congratulations to Richard Yoakum, who added 1 person to our team last month. Yeah, you know, I watch a lot of your posts on social media, and you are all killing it. And, you know, just be yourself and share your journey authentically, what the highs and the lows. Sharing the lows is always the hardest part, sharing those struggles. But like Melanie said, that breeds connection. And I believe that 1,000%, because I can tell the posts where I'm just throwing something up there, not really putting a lot of thought behind it, and something that I do think about and is really coming from the heart, I can tell people gravitate more towards those types of posts. And, you know, I'm reaching more people that way. So, but we have a great call lined up for you guys. We're not going to keep you too late, but we did want to incorporate a little mini power, however many minutes we have left in the call, to kind of knock out some things that Melanie is going to teach you guys about Instagram. I don't know how many people had a chance to watch that Instagram training video, but Melanie reached out to Jen and was like, hey, girl, like, hook me up. I need, like, what can you help us with? And she was so giving to record a special call that not a lot of people got. I looked at the YouTube, I think it was like 10 views, and sent it to Melanie. So thank you, Melanie, for reaching out to her. And like she said, you know, we're trying to do everything we can to bring the best to you guys and to help you grow. And we're learning, and this is a constant learning process. So don't think if you're in, you know, don't think that anybody has it all figured out. We're all learning together. Some of us may have a little bit more experience, but this is, you continue to learn and grow throughout your coaching, career and in this business, just like you grow in your own personal, on your own personal journey. So Melanie, you want to kick it off, girl, with the Instagram training and just kind of go over some of those highlights?
Yeah, and I think, Courtney, did you want to share something?
Oh, go ahead.
I saw a hand, or were you just stretching?
No, I'm good. Oh, hold on.
Okay. Yeah, I can hear you. Okay. All right. I just want to make sure you weren't trying to.
So I can't see. I don't know how to unhide
myself. Oh!
So I'm like, okay. I have no idea what I'm doing on the screen.
I saw a hand. I didn't know if you had something you want to say. Okay. So, yes, this is going to be our power hour. Does anybody have anything they want to say about the training? If you did watch it, did you have any questions? Did you have anything you wanted to share? No? Okay. So what I had done, and I put this in our group, I'm just trying to look back at our website. In the post, I don't think I tagged everybody, but the post I just made where I was reminding everybody about the team call, in the comments below, you'll see I made, I'm such a nerd. I made notes. So I took notes for you. And then also I have the link to the video in case you missed that. And then I also have a link to the website she references to find hashtags. So, and I just checked that out and it was okay. I'm going to play around with it a little bit more, but basically she advises us to use that website and then you put in a hashtag and then it pops out other ones. I felt like a lot of them that were there were really, really broad. So I would encourage you, if you do use that website, just be mindful as you're typing it in, because when you are putting a hashtag on your photo, they say not to choose one that has like a million because you'll get lost. Like you want to try to stay around. What do they say, Devin? Like 10 to 30,000? Is that like a good measure? So that way it's not too big, but it's not too small. So just throwing that out there. And all of that is all together, and I just posted that. So if nobody wants to say anything.
Melanie, can I say? Oh, go ahead, Steph.
I've watched a couple of videos in the last couple of days, and I'm pretty sure this is the one where they said something about the color wheel. Is that correct in this video? And yes. You were like, make sure you guys do the color wheel. I went back to our Coach Basics to see if I could find it, and I had a hard time finding it. Is there any way you could link that in on where you were just talking about too, so I could do that? I even Googled color wheel, and I couldn't find anything.
I'll post it in the group.
Okay, it's cool. From module 4, how to start building your brand and posting. So when you first open it, because I had the same problem too, trying to go back and find it. When you first open it, all you see is writing. It's the one that talks about educate, inspire, entertain, connect. And you have to actually scroll down to see it. So you're probably just popping in each one. Just look. And you just scroll down.
You said module 4 and like educate something. Okay.
The name of it is how to start building your brand and posting on social media.
Okay.
And basically she's just telling you to, who are you, and come up. I think there's 12 pieces of the pie. I wrote down 14 just because I kept going. But yeah, you're going to start there. So if you've watched the video, you know, she prompts you to do that first. Start there, find out, okay, first of all, who are you talking to? Because if you're talking to everybody, guess what? You're actually not talking to anybody because nobody, it's too broad. So definitely zero in and find your niche. So that's the first thing. Who are you? Who are you trying to attract? And then step 2 would be to find a hashtag that you want to search. And then step 3 is what we're doing right now. So everybody, like, open up whatever you use for your Instagram. And I'm going to put us on a timer. So step 1 for tonight's call, for tonight's do now, is to search a hashtag. So you're going to go to your little like magnifying glass, for those of you who are like totally new to IG, because I know some people will be watching the playback. You're going to go to that little thing that looks like a magnifying glass, and you're just going to search, put in a hashtag that you feel represents you. So like if your fur babies are your babies, like fur baby mama, you know? And so that's where that website displaypurposes.com comes in handy, because fur baby mama if you have like five or six other choices, and that would be an easy way to just quickly do it. So it's 8:44. So we've got three categories that we're doing, Devin. How long should I time us? 7 minutes apiece would be 21 minutes total.
Let's do like 5 minutes apiece.
5 minutes? Okay. All right, so let me get my clock. So your task right now is to put a hashtag in that search and find 20 people to follow in 5 minutes. So just do your best, but always be timing yourself when you're working at home because it makes you go faster. Okay, 5 minutes, go.
And copy these, Melanie, like into our notes section. Are we creating like our hashtag list right now?
Yeah, you can.
Yeah.
You can do that. I didn't even think of that. So the three things I'm going to have you guys do, search a hashtag and follow 20 people. Number two, like and quick comment of those people. And then the last one to track them.
Okay. Never mind.
But I mean, if that makes more sense, that's just kind of what I came up with. I'm trying to play music for you guys and it's like frozen.
Now I'm missing out on that. We've come so far. I guess I'm fine. Now I'm worried.
That was 5 minutes. I literally found one person.
I found a ton.
Oh my God, that was so hard. You know what make it faster? If I already had the hashtags, because that was what was taking me so long. But this is how you learn, right? You do it, try it again.
That's what I felt too. I started feeling discouraged. I'm like, I feel like I just keep finding other coaches. Like, I don't want to follow other coaches, you know? Like, I want to find a hashtag that other people aren't using. Yeah. So like you said, it's like, no, I don't want to just push follow, you know?
Yeah.
I think it's really important that we all do that color wheel exercise because it really gets you thinking. And maybe we should, I don't know, next call, we should, say, for instance, everybody's like, okay, Stephanie, what's something that we would describe you or something that's unique that we see in you? Because the other day, Tracy was like, Devin, your curly hair, like, that's your, like, you need to be talking to women with curly hair. I didn't even think about that, but it's like things because I have curly hair and it's something that I see every day, but like the other day too, Kristen was, we were at the trampoline park and she was like, oh yeah, I used to do gymnastics. And I was like, ex-gymnast, like you need to, like you can really dial in, you know, to your niche, but you have to figure that out first. Like, who are we trying to talk to? So that exercise is going to be very helpful for all of us.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
That's good. You just gave me an idea for, because I put alcoholic recovered, I get the ex-drinker.
Yeah.
The ones I was just trying to search, and that she talks about this in the training too. She says, the exercise of finding the hashtags is really tedious, but she said it actually teaches you a lot because I've been using sober AF a lot. And guess what? When I just look that up, it's all coaches. So all the time I'm using that sober AF, I'm not attracting my niche. I'm attracting other coaches. I didn't know that until tonight. So even doing this part, and refining our hashtags, and I know people have been talking about this forever, but it's like you don't understand it until you actually do it yourself, and you're like, oh, that's what they're talking about.
And it's going to continue to change, mm-hmm. because those hashtags and that, like, whatever's popular this month and something, a fad, you know, comes up and everybody jumps on that bandwagon and all the coaches jump on those hashtags and it's time to change and time to evolve. So we're going to continue. This isn't, you know, this is a ever evolving process of hashtags. That's why we're like,
it's like completely new to me. Like I always kind of like, I don't know, not made fun of it, but like, you know, like hashtag, what you got a hashtag stuff for, you know, like I never used them before really. So like it's kind of a struggle with the new play or new ball field for sure.
It's like another language till you understand it.
For sure. I'm like, I already wrote the post. Like now I got to come up with some quirky thing to put after. I don't know. That's too hard.
I feel you, girl. All right. So the next thing I had on my list was like a post and quick comment, but I'm realizing after I'm giving you guys this list, like, you kind of have to track your people. Now, I will say in the training, she says she doesn't track everybody she follows because that takes too much time. She only tracks the people who, if she looks at them and looks at their page, she's like, oh, my God, like, they are my perfect match. And then those 10 to 20 people a month are the only people she engages with. Well, I shouldn't say only. The people she pays the most attention to that she's trying to attract. And she said it's daily. All up in their stories, all up in liking and commenting, all up in the conversations. And it makes so much sense because her whole thing is quality, not quantity. So
if you're trying to like spread yourself so thin, and this is what I've been doing, and obviously like I could be doing a lot better, which is why I'm willing to change it. But instead of watering myself down to try to talk to like 100 people, if I only have 10 to 20 people, imagine the difference that's going to make and the difference it's going to make for them to join my team. And she says, she sends that first message 2 weeks later, boom, it's a hard invite. She doesn't beat around the bush. She doesn't try to find like a little way into the conversation. It's just like, look, hey, you would be really good at this thing that I do called coaching, and edify them and tell them how inspirational, whatever. And then she sends them a video, and it's just like, boom, boom, boom. Like, she doesn't mess around. And there's a reason why she's one of the top coaches, because she's like laser focused and she goes for it. So yeah, the next thing on my list was the like a post and quick comment. The goal is 20 people. So obviously that's people you're already got your eye on. Maybe go to your stories. This is a learning curve, you guys. Does that sound good, Devin?
Yeah.
So we're going on there and liking things and commenting as well.
Yeah, so like if I use stories as a filter to say who's got their eyes on me, who's paying attention to me. So if you go in your story, you can see down there, seen by 109, I can click on that and I see all those people.
Girl, you got I got like 49 that look at mine. You got twice as many as me.
Here's the thing, though. How many followers do you have?
In the 200s.
So you're actually doing better than me, because I have 6,000 followers and I only have 100 people looking at my story. You only have 200 followers. 25% of your people are engaging, looking at you, paying attention to you. So in that respect, your account's better than mine. And that's why I'm willing to try this training. I have all these people, I'm not engaging with them. So that's why I'm willing to try this new way.
For sure.
So, sorry guys, I just got really long-winded. I don't even know, I didn't even start it.
Okay. And go to we're going to our stories, and then whoever's watching your story, go to their page, follow them if you're not already following them, and then like a few of their pictures and comment more than 3 words on their on a couple of their posts.
Thank you.
All right, that was 5 minutes. What'd you guys do?
Pretty good.
Good. It really takes practice to get into a habit of doing this every day, you know? So just like anything, you know, it just takes practice setting aside 10 minutes every day to go through your stories and engage with people. Yeah. Go to their page.
Real good. I just want to point out, let me turn this down a little bit. Just so you know, like the level where she's working at, and she's been doing it for 3 years, so she's probably really efficient. She follows 100 people a day.
Yeah.
50 comments a day. Obviously, you have to unfollow them. I don't know what her system is for that. She doesn't talk about it. She only tracks when the profile stands out. The ones she actually wants to recruit, those are the only ones she tracks. And when she chooses those 10 to 20, it's a daily engagement. Looking at their stories, liking, commenting, sending messages. Initial message, just hello, how are you, non-Beachbody. And then in 2 weeks, boom, the hard invite. So another tip she says for finding hashtags, look at a big non-Beachbody account. So like for me, it would be like Gabby Bernstein. And you can find followers there. She talks about following big accounts that are like mom bloggers. And then going through there and finding her people. And she said the cool thing about this whole process is that you might think, and it just happened to me, you might think the hashtag you're using is actually attracting your niche. And once you go looking and fishing and looking for those people, and you're like, oh my gosh, no, those are not my people. So I think this is going to be really good to help us really zero in on that avatar. So last task is then to track if you have anybody track worthy. If not, go back and pick up some slack from something else that you missed. You guys down for 5 more minutes? You got 5 more minutes in you?
Yep.
All right, go.
Bye. into the dark. Hide away, they say, we don't want your broken heart. I'm going to be ashamed of all the scars. Run away, they say, no one will love you as you are. I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us. For we are glorious. When the sharpest words wanna cut me down, I'm gonna send a flare, I'm gonna drown them out. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me. Look up, cause here I come. I'm marching on to the beat of drum. I'm not scared to be seen. I make no apologies. This is me.
Yeah, I'm hurt.
Quick. All right, guys. Well, now you know what we're doing. So now you just got to do it. That's the hard part, right? So if you were knocking out a power hour, even a power half hour, a power pocket, I mean, gosh, we talk about the power pocket 10 minutes at a time, you know? If you're doing that, like, feel free to use Rise and Shine. Hop on live. I mean, you might not have a Zoom account, which there is one that you can get for free, just saying. So you should definitely put that on your list of things to do eventually, if not already. Feel free to hop on live and just be like, hey, this is what I'm doing. Because even if somebody can't be on live, they can go back and like sit with you as you're doing. You can kind of talk them through it. So use our page, be leaders, step up and, you know, share what you're doing. And I feel like the more of us do that, the stronger we're going to be and the faster we're going to grow. So does anybody have anything else?
Melanie, can we all of us print our color wheels, fill them out, and then post them on the Rise and Shine page? Let's,
how do we print them out? Because when I look at it, it's like you scroll down. Is that an actual document you can print?
Oh, I posted it in the Rise and Shine group a while back.
Oh, I see.
And I tagged everybody on the call. Let me tag you, Melanie.
Okay, good. Yes. And I'll print it there because I was actually inside the training when I was looking.
Yeah, you can like save that picture to your phone or to your computer and print it out, or I don't know, fill it out in one of your PicMonkey or whatever you use. You can do it there too, but
yeah. I think I'd be drawing a circle with monsters on it.
Yeah, so let's do that. Let's really put some thought into who we're trying to attract and who, what makes us unique, what makes us colorful, and let's share those with each other.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Anybody have anything else? Thank you for carving out this time for you to come and connect, because, you know, this is how we stay engaged and we stay connected. I know this call wasn't really the most fun one to have, but this is what it means to be a businesswoman. Sometimes we have to have business meetings and just get a little dirty. So good job tonight, everyone. Keep up with your consistency, myself included. I know I've been kind of slipping lately. So let me be a better leader for you and show you that, hey, I sometimes am not on my A game, and that's okay because tomorrow's a new day. So light and love, beginning of a new month, set those intentions, be specific. Where do you want to be on August the 31st? And let's freaking do it. All right. Love you, ladies.
Love you, guys.
Bye.
Bye.